Let's begin our second session with lesson 5A.
وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ.
And indeed, we have made easy the Quran for remembrance and for dhikr, for understanding. So is there anybody out there who wishes to understand? So we all are, alhamdulillah. In this lesson, we shall study the purpose of revelation. Purpose of revelation of Quran and some grammar. And by the end of this lesson, we shall have learned 32 new words which occur in Quran with repetition almost 17,000 times. Alhamdulillah. So just a note about the homeworks. 5 minutes of recitation of the Quran every day, inshallah. We promise that to ourselves?
Inshallah.
That's a minimum. And we shall study from the book as well as from the vocabulary sheet. Listen to the MP3, ask your partner, and recite different surahs in Salah. Let's begin today's lesson with two key words, Tadabbur and Tadhakkur. So the purpose of revelation, as mentioned in the Quran, is pondering over its verses, Tadabbur, and Tadhakkur, that is receiving admonition, lessons from Quran. And the ayah that we are going to recite and talk about is
كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب.
This is a book, and the book meaning the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we have sent this book onto you, Ilaika, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a book which is full of blessings, Mubarakun. And how do we get these blessings from the book? By liyadabbaru ayati, so that they ponder over its verses, waliyatadhakkara, and they take admonishment, lessons. Who takes them? Ulul albab, the ones who have intellect, the ones who are called aqalmand. Let's study this ayah in depth and try to figure out, are we fulfilling the purpose of revelation. A question comes to mind. The purpose of revelation as defined by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran for us is a lesson. Are we taking this lesson? Let's do this word for word. Now just to remind you, we are going to study the ayats in four different ways. We shall learn the word for word translation, the running translation, the grammar, and the mafhoom or the concept from the ayat. So far, we have not been studying the grammar of the ayat because we haven't studied much grammar. But by lesson 13, inshallah, we would have studied enough grammar so that we will apply those grammar rules to this ayat and understand them. So for now, it's word for word translation, running translation, and the concept, mafhoom, or the message from the ayah. So kitabun, kitab, it's a book. Anzalnahu, kitab, the jama is kutubun. Now here, we have so far talked about ism, and the plural of ism we said was made in a way by adding waw noon and ya noon. Correct? Like Muslim, Muslimoon, Mu'min, Mu'minoon, Mu'mineen. But there is another form of plural which does not follow that rule. So the first rule was the rule of solid plural where we add the waw noon and ya noon. Kafir, kafirun, kafirin, salih, salihun, salihin. The other form of plural is where it does not follow the rule. So we call it the broken plural. Because it breaks the word and rearranges it, adds or subtracts to the original. So it's kutubun. And we have many examples like that. For example, the plural for qalam is aqlam. The plural for bayt is buyut. And we shall learn many, many more. But basically the idea is there are two types of plurals. The first type that we learned was called solid plural. The one in which the singular, all of it was present in the plural along with wa noon and ya noon. And the other plural is which does not follow those rules, we call them broken plurals. Anyway, kitabun, anzalna, and who is separate? Ata'ur Rahman, you want to know that, right? So the who is separated. Anzalna means we revealed. So, na, remember, is the same na, Rabbuna, Kitabuna, so na. So, we, concept of we revealed it. What did we reveal? Who, it. So, Kitabun Anzalna, who. This who refers to the book. That's the concept I want you to take from here. That this is, it's a book, we have sent it down. We have sent what down? Anzalna, who, this book. It's a pronoun. So, this book has been sent down, ilayka, who, there is no neutral gender in Arabic, remember, either you have masculine or you have feminine. It's not like English where you have an it. Everything that we talk about will be either masculine or feminine. Like we talked about kursi. Kursi was masculine. So, who, kitab is masculine. If it was feminine, what would we have used here? Kitabuha. Her book. So ha would have been used if the noun was feminine. Okay. So kitabun anzalna. We reveal this book. Ilaika, towards you. See, ilaika broken down is ila plus ka.
So the previous word again, the anzala, anzalna. What's the original word? Is the nazala?
Anzala. If you break it separately, we're going to do this in detail further on, but it's like this. Anzala.
What is Nazala?
We shall do that. Okay. So all these different forms of verbs. So we sent down. Anzalna, we sent down. What it? So book, we sent it down. Ilaika, towards you. O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ilayka mubarakun. Mubarak, just like Eid Mubarak. You say Eid Mubarak, and Mubarak means on whom the barakat is given. Mubarak. So never say Mubarak, say Mubarak. And we'll learn in the next course, course 2, why we say Mubarak and not Mubarak. But Mubarak is what you want to use. The one on whom the barakah is given. Right? Mubarak. It's like this, like, remember, Zalim, Mazloom, Abid, Mabud, Ghadib, Mabdu. So it's like this, Mubarak, Mubarak. The one on whom the barakah comes. So it is full of blessings. So feel the infinite mercy and kindness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have given us a book that is full of blessings. And we don't study it. It's given. In fact, we'll talk about something very interesting. How happy should we be to receive this book? The happiness is shown by our attachment. And the attachment is not by putting it in the form of a small amulet around your neck or perhaps on the shelf. It's shown by our attachment by reading, studying and spreading it. So note the words. We stop at barakah. Typically, in our part of the world, we understand that there's a barakah in this Quran and we try to get this barakah by putting it over the head of, you know, when, during marriage or when someone dies, we call in some people to recite it. So we think the barakah is going to come from there. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not stop here, Mubarak. Goes on to say, well, Allimu, remember, teach what you learn, and Uktubu, write. And I already saw some brothers doing the workbook. That's what I want you to do. Start doing the workbook. So how do we get those blessings? Li yaddabbaru. We have revealed this book unto you, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, full of blessings, so that. So li over here means so that. Li will have many meanings. Remember we had words, those connections like be, min. So li is one of them, letters, meaning so that. So li is separate, yaddabbaru is separate. So that they ponder, yaddabbaru, so that they ponder, they reflect, they contemplate. Ayatihi on its verses. So ayah is verse, also means sign. And ayatihi, and the plural of ayah is ayat. Same way, like we did Muslimah. Muslimah was Muslimat, Mu'mina was Mu'minat, so ayatun is ayat. But there's something very interesting. First of all, this is written, do you see this alif with another alif on top of it? This is a way of writing an extra alif. So the mad also means the same. So there are two alifs here. See, there's another alif here. So this is actually, this is like this. One, one. Then ya. A, ya, tihi. So, we're talking about ayat. He, its verses. Whose verses? Quran's verses. So, understand how it goes. Liyadabaru, so that they ponder ayati over its verses. And what else? Yadabaru, ponder means think over. For example, can you read a math book like a storybook? No. So when you are reading a newspaper, you are actually, you're not pondering, you're just reading it. But if you read a math book, you need to stop, reflect, understand. So it's like math. So pondering is only possible after understanding. So the purpose of revelation given to us is reflect upon its verses, ponder upon its verses. And remember we talked about the rights of the Quran? Did we?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it was tadabbur.
Normally brothers are used to ayat
tuhu,
but there's a reason why.
We will talk about this separately. But basically what the brother is trying to refer to, and maybe I'll just point it out and we'll do it separately, differently, elsewhere. And we did this, we talked about it, for example, we said kitab, bun, bin and ban were three versions, remember? So they all have same meaning. So if I had a word ayah, ayatuhu, ayatahu or ayatihi, from technical point of view, they would mean the same. But we use it only ayati, and we'll study that later why. So technically understand, the reason could be a grammar reason, but as far as the word is concerned, let me give another one. Rabbu, Rabbi, Rabba. Three different ways of writing. We only use the one which is relevant, but they all have the same basic meaning. You get this difference? So don't be confused for now whether you see it in a certain way. Okay? Like we said, Rabbuna, our Rabb. We can say Rabbana or Rabbina. Three different ways. They will all mean our Rabb. But we will only use the one which is relevant in the sentence. Remember, we talked about structure of the word and structure of the sentence. So when you come into sentence, we'll talk about why we use a particular form. But this is the basic course. We're starting at the point where you want to understand what the words mean. So, ayatihi, its verses. So they ponder over its verses. And not just that, wa means and, so that li yatazakkara, and so that they receive admonition. Yatazakkara, that is to receive lesson. Like there's a word zikr, we all know about it, or zakara, that is to remember something. So this is a sort of remembering in which you get a lesson from the remembering. You tell someone again and again something, that is the zakkar. So there is admonition. Our objective over here is not to study the word litayatazakkara, that comes on later. Right now we are doing just the basic message from this ayah, so that they receive lessons, admonition. Who? See, li is used in two different ways. In this, it means so that li yatadabbaru and li yatazakkara. And we used li earlier with the word Allah, lillahi. And what was the meaning over there? For alhamdulillah. So there the lam was used with a noun, and here lam is used with a verb. We will study this in later lessons, but the word lam is important in different contexts. And so they receive admonition. Who receives admonition? Ulul albab. Ulu means those, the ones who carry. For example, we say Ulu is one who owns something. He is part of it. So who is? The one who is akal or understanding. Al-Bab. So lub, and the plural of lub is al-Bab. So we're talking about those of understanding. So it's very interesting ayah. Let's talk about this ayah in depth. First of all, receiving admonition, that means bringing it into our life. The lessons of the ayah bringing into our life. So there are two aspects. The purpose of revelation is one, to ponder over its verses, so that they ponder over its verses and they take lessons from it. Who? The ones of who are of intellect, the intelligent, the ones of akal. So there are two questions that arise here. First of all, what does admonition mean? To take a lesson. Let me give an example. If a child puts his hand into the fire, what happens? Burns. What does he do? Takes it out. Does he put his hand in the fire again? No. So what has he done? He has learned a lesson. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us a lot of stories about different nations before us. They did not agree to the ayats, or did not follow the ahkam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they were punished. So we should learn in the same way. For example, there was a nation that deceived others by not giving them their full weight. The nation of other Shoaib alayhi salam. So what happened to them? They were destroyed. If we do the same, we shall also be dealt in a similar fashion. So it is supposed to give us a way to receive admonition. The second aspect is, if this ayah means it is for the people of intellect, what does that mean to me? Does that mean only the people of intellect can get admonition? Or does it mean something else? What is that? So let's first be very clear about this ayah. What is the message from the ayah? The message from the ayah is that we have revealed this book unto you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has been revealed so that we ponder over its verses and take lessons. Who takes lessons? And the intelligent take lessons from it. Is the message clear first of all?
Yeah.
Okay, secondly, are only the intelligent people qualified to take lessons? No, it's the other way around. Those who take lessons from it are the ones who are intelligent. Just let me finish that. It's very important to understand that the people who do not take lessons from it, no matter how many degrees they have, no matter how learned they are thought of in this world, they have failed. The proof? The Quran. Surah Al-Mulk. Clearly on that day when they are thrown into the fire, they will say, وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُوا أَوْ نَعْقِلُوا. They will say, had we listened or had we akal intellect, مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ, we would not have been with the people of the Jahannam. That means it is a very clear. So in this world, we cannot call people akalmand if they are not getting lessons from the Quran. The definition from the Quran is the definition of intellectual people. The people of intellect are those that derive their lessons from the Quran. So this is, where is it? We gone further. So tadabbur or tadakkur, how do we bring it into our lives? The question is, if we want to do tadabbur and you want to do tazakkur. Yes, question?
Here it says tadabbur and tazakkur, but in the ayat it uses ya instead of ta.
Okay, let me clarify. The way the verbs are, there is a root word or the main verb, that is tadabbara, right? And like there are, like in English, or let's say in Urdu, we say, in English we say that he ate, he will eat, he eats, I will eat, they will all eat. They all have slightly different ways of saying. So over here we are saying,